Recently, the media went crazy for research reporting that probiotics could actually be harmful for us. These days, most of us have been told to take them. So what's the deal? Should we be abandoning them altogether? Are probiotics actually bad for you? Hi, I'm Sophia from GUTXY, and we let your gut guide you to better digestive health. Probiotic supplementation has become a huge market. In the US alone, it's estimated 3.9 million adults consume them. Up to 60% of healthcare providers prescribe them to their patients, making probiotics one of the most commonly consumed dietary supplements. Why is this? Well, probiotics have many reported health benefits. They're thought to alleviate gastrointestinal symptoms, strengthen the immune system, help protect against various diseases, and promote general well-being. Certain strains of probiotics, particularly from the types called lactobacillus and bifidobacteria, are continually noted to be effective. A systematic review of 14 clinical trials found that bifidobacterium lactis, for instance, can help with constipation. Overall, probiotics can improve gut transit time, stool frequency, and stool consistency. Nevertheless, there's still a great need for further evidence-based proof on the impact of probiotics in us as humans. Now, going back to these recent findings, what's going on here? The study took 19 people and gave them 11 of the most commonly found strains of probiotics. Only 8 of them had any notable colonization in the digestive tracts. For the rest, the probiotics didn't help them boost their good bacteria. So, they do show that when taking standard probiotic strains, some people are naturally resistant to the bacteria, whilst for others, the bacteria will readily grow and flourish. By looking into the participants' normal microbiome and gene expression, they could also predict who would have successful bacterial growth. Probiotics are generally recommended as a combination or following a course of antibiotics. However, one study reported that this could actually do more harm than good. Antibiotics are not selective and can actively destroy all bacteria, both good and bad. These findings showed probiotics didn't always help the gut return to normal. In certain cases, it even delayed the participants' own gut bacteria for months. What's the takeaway? We have to consider that these are limited by small sample sizes, and further research studies are required to reach conclusions. These studies are not enough to override all the previous research reporting the benefits of certain probiotic strains. Still, the interesting findings do highlight how, as with most things, personalized solutions are the way to go. As work in this field continues, researchers hope to be able to tailor probiotic treatments to the individual based on the types of microbes already present in your gut, as well as other factors. Till then, in addition to a healthy, fiber-rich diet and active lifestyle, taking well-documented probiotics are a good way to support your gut health.